and SM2. Now I'm going to explain you question number 12 of exercise 1A. And the question is, the net force Newton needed to push a block along a horizontal surface is directly proportional to the mass of the block. Here in this question, they have said that the force that you are applying is directly proportional to the mass of the block. You are pushing a block. So here the force is directly proportional to the mass of the block. Here the force is denoted by F and the mass of the block is denoted by M. So here the value of M and F is given. So you can find out the value of K. And you can make an equation connecting F and M. So the first part is, you have to make an equation connecting F and M. And F is directly proportional to M. So you will write the equation as F is directly proportional to M. And here the force and mass is given. So you will put the values to find out the value of K. And the force is 49. And K is, you have to find out K, and the mass is 5. See, 49 by 5, you have to find out the value of K. You will move this 5 to here, it is multiplying, when it will come to this side, it will divide. So the value of K is, 9.8. Now in part 2, they are saying, find the value of M when M is equal to 14. So first make the equation, F is equal to KM. So F is equal to 9.8 M. Your first part is done. Now in part 2, you have to find out the value of F when M is 14. So again, use the same equation, F is equal to KM. Force, you have to find out. So put the value of K and M. The value of K is 9.8. And the value of M is 14. So you will get the answer, and that is 137.2. Now in part 3, they are saying, calculate the value of M. You have to find out M. And when F is equal to 215.6. So you will use the same equation, F is equal to KM. Put the values of F, that is 215.6. And put the unit of this force, and that is Newton. Now put the value of K, and that is 9.8. And M you have to find out. You have to find out M, so you will move this 9.8 to this side. 9.8 is multiplying with then M. When it will come to this side, it will divide. So the value of M is 22. Okay, the unit of mass is kilogram. So you will put the unit. Don't forget to put the unit with the answer. Here the third part is done. Now in fourth part, they are saying, draw the graph of F against M. So before drawing the graph, you will make the table. And fourth part, before drawing the graph, you will make the table. Here in this table, you will assume the values. Here it is F and here it is M. The equation is, F is directly proportional to KM. So you will assume the value of M to get the value of F. So M, you are assuming the value 0 and 1. So you will find out the value of, by using the equation, F is equal to KM. So F is equal to, what is K? K is given to you, and that is 9.8. And what is M? Here it is 0. So the value of F is 0. So you write down the value of F, that is 0. Now put M is equal to 1. Here you have put M is equal to 0. Now put M is equal to 1. So F is equal to KM. So F is equal to, K is 9.8 and M is 1. So F is equal to 9.8. So here you will put the value of F, that is 9.8. Now you will draw the graph. You can use the graph paper to draw the graph. Here you will draw the graph F against M. So you can use M is 0 and 1. So on x-axis you will write 0 and 1. You have taken 1 unit. Now see, it is 9.8. So you can select the scale on F, means on Y axis. You can take the scale of 2 units. You can take the scale of 3 units. As I am going to take the scale of 2 units on Y axis on force. So here it is. I will write 2, 4, 6, 8. I will extend this and 10. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Here, see the table. F and M both are 0. Where both are 0, here it is 0 at origin, 0. So M is 0 over here and F is 0 over here. So here you will put the dot. And the other value is 9.8 and 1. On M is 1 and extend it till 9.8. So it will be near 10. So the second dot will be here. So join this dot. The graph should be straight line and here you are getting straight line. So now write down the values. Here it was M was 0 and F was also 0. And here M was 1 and F was 9.8. This is your answer.